But Doctor, if we've landed, where are we? That is what I'm trying to find out, Gillian. Let's see if I flick the switch here, I might be able to switch on the scanner. All systems are functioning negatively. Oh, wow. I guess I'll have to crisscross a few wires. John, pass me that screwdriver in the far corner, would you? This? Yes. Thank you. Yes, I think I see the problem. Well, don't keep us in suspense. Oh, just a few wires got crossed there. It's a little complicated, but nothing I can't handle. There! There we go. What is this place? I don't know. It seems to be some sort of power complex.
Should we look outside?
Oh, what a splendid idea. Right. No, wait! Not physically outside, but what I can do is we can flip the scanner around to see our surroundings. May give us another brief understanding of where we are.
If the monitor can do that, how come you've never done it before? Well, most of the time we never really needed to use it, John, but in this case, it's a different scenario.
Right. Oh, of course, I know where we are now. Where? Well, don't you see? We're in the far future, I'd say about 2046. 2046, yes. A little more advanced technology, because, you see, this institute outside us is the Newton Complex Institute in London.
You mean to say that we're in London, 2046?
Well, yes, yes indeed. Seems that things must have moved on since then.
Looks like Dracula's castle.
Well, you're right about the castle bit, Gillian. It used to be a fortress in the Middle Ages. Right, I think we can take a look outside, physically now.
Wow! How cool is this?
Yes, I'd say exactly the same thing. It's a little out of your time, but I do believe that everything seems to be in order as it should have been.
Hey, Gillian, check out this computer. I bet it can tell us more about where we are. Now, John, wait!
Travel mat is the ultimate form of travel. Control center of this prison system is the moon, serving receptions all major cities on Earth. Travel mat provides an instantaneous means of public travel, transports raw materials and vital food supplies to all parts of the world.
Travel mat? Huh. More like a flying carpet.
Shush, John, I'm trying to listen. Travel mat supersedes all conventional forms of transport, using a principle of determination at all points of departure, and rematerialization at the point of arrival in the special cubicles, departure in all employments and instantaneous, faster than light. Although the system is still in its stages, it is completely automated and foolproof against power failure.
Yeah, well, we have our own system, thank you. Even though it's not foolproof.
No, John, I hardly think that's important.
But it's only 2046, and they've already found a new means of public travel.
You're right, Doctor. Things have changed since 1963.
Well, even in the 1960s, Gillian, you were already moving into a world where technology was become a vital part of it. It's only natural that things should move on and become more advanced.
Yeah, but how are we going to get out of here?
Well, I just think... What's going on? Who are they?
Intruders.
Go and see what's wrong. Strutler, Ronson here. We have a situation down here. They've been compromised. Three intruders have managed to break their way into the centre. How? We don't know yet. Pullman's gone to check it out.
Well, if anything pops up with the danger to the centre, then let me know.
Strutler out.
Is something the matter, Strutler?
Oh, no, not at all, Professor.
Good, then continue.
Are you sure your system's automating up to official scale, Professor?
I can promise you now, Strutler, that all my systems are operating at maximum efficiency. Nothing can go wrong. Nothing.
You say that now. We've had many catastrophes in the past. The past is the past, Strutler. I know what I'm doing.
I have experience in this field, and I've worked with computers very well. It's only natural that my own one should operate to its maximum efficiency.
Well, if you're sure, I'm the genius of the operation, Strutler, not you.
Doctor.
I'd put that down if I were you. Don't worry, I'm not going to shoot you. I just want to know who you are.
Oh, well, this is Gillian, and that's John, and I'm the Doctor.
How did you get into our secret workshops if you're not a member of staff?
Oh, the usual way, really. We just materialise.
You seriously expect me to believe that?
Like it or not, mate, it's the only excuse you have to go on.
I'd like to know more about this travel map your computer was talking about.
Oh, brilliant. That's the last thing I need. Another scientist.
Beg your pardon?
Look, you're obviously expeditionaries from the Scientific Bureau. You want to see Professor Burt?
What you're talking about. Or do you, or don't you?
Well, Well, if he's a scientist and he knows about the computers, well, then yes, I'd like to see him.
He's in his lab. I'll take you to him, but... That doesn't mean I haven't got my eye on you. All of you.
Very well,
Funny man. I think he's a little confused somehow. Yeah, he seems insistent that we're some sort of scientific people. Well, if he can lead us to the person who can tell us more about these computers, well, then I'm fascinated to know more. Can't seriously say we're going along with it.
Well, why not? It's not causing any harm, and we're not really much of an intrusion.
Yeah, well, that trigger-happy chap's got an eye on us. I don't think he trusts us, Doctor. It doesn't matter if he trusts us or not, John. The only thing is that we're taking us to the person who can tell us more about these computers.
Professor Burt will see you under supervision.
Oh, very well. Take us to him.
Professor, I brought those people along to see you from the Scientific Bureau. Sherman.
Professor Burt, I presume.
How do you do? I'm the Doctor.
Nice to meet you.
From what Pullman tells me, you seem to be a expert in computers, Doctor.
Well, I wouldn't go as far as to say I'm an expert, Professor, but I do dabble. Yes, I do dabble.
Oh, so this is your main computer?
No, this is just the pet project I dabble with. The National Automatic Radiophonic Robotic Automating Transcriptive Operative Radio.
Or N.A.R.R.A.T.O.R for short.
Yes, N.A.R.R.A.T.O.R.
This is my computer. The Keller machine.
And what does Keller stand for?
It doesn't really stand for anything. I named him after my father, Keller Burt.
I see you. That's very clever.
Yes, it is indeed. You know, Doctor, I go so far as to say that it's the only one of its existence in the world. It's at least 10 years ahead of its time.
And why is that, then?
Well, Miss Gillian. Her name is Gillian.
Well, Gillian, I'll explain. Keller may not be the biggest computer in the world, but it's most certainly the most advanced.
It can handle mathematical and scientific problems well outside the range of any other computer in existence.
Because, you see, I am about to link this up with every computer around the world as a central intelligence. A sort of big problem solver, if you like.
I don't understand.
Well, maybe not yet. It's missing brain activity. I may need a volunteer for this.
Well, I'll volunteer if you like, Professor. I always like to do what I can to help progress the advancements of science.
Thank you, Doctor. You're kind. If you could hold your arm out for me, please. Now, the wire that you're holding is already connected to Keller, which is wired up to the N.A.R.R.A.T.O.R. computer behind you. Now, I'm going to switch on the N.A.R.R.A.T.O.R., which will send out a link to Keller, which will send a little electric shock buzz through the wire that you're holding.
What will I achieve from this? Oh, well, it will give the computer brain activity, be able to program something.
So I'll be the first contact this computer has.
Yes, exactly.
Ready to switch on? Now.
Sure, you all right?
I'm fine. I just got a little bit of a buzz out of that. I didn't expect it to be as nasty as it was.
I did warn you. Well, it's been nice chatting to you, Doctor, and your friends, but I'm afraid I must retire for the afternoon. It's my lunch break.
Yes, of course. Well, thank you for giving up your time to explain things to us more clearly, Professor.
My pleasure. If you have any questions about Keller or N.A.R.R.A.T.O.R., please come and talk to me. I am the expert in the situation, after all.
I see. Well,
come on, John. Gillian.
We've got trouble coming up.
Trouble? What kind of trouble?
A power failure. Better let Burt know. I'm onto it.
Professor, Professor Burt?
Yeah.
You're sure about this?
Well, of course I'm not sure. Why do you think I volunteered for his little experiment?
I think Professor Burt knows a great deal more than he's telling us.
So what do we do?
Well, I'm going to go back to his lab and see if I can know more about his Keller machine.
You two go back to the room where the TARDIS is and wait for me there.
All right. And you sure you don't know what happened?
I was just passing by and the door was open.
He's dead.
How? He?
Well, he must have electrocuted himself.
It may seem that way, Mr. Strutler, but you're completely wrong.
How?
Well, I monitored his death on the professor's computer thing, but according to that, it shows all the indications that he died from drowning.
That's ridiculous.
You can read the report and see for yourself, sir.
Well, you're right, Pullman. Bronson's lungs are full of water. He drowned all right, but in the middle of a perfectly dry room.
We need to get his body out of here before anyone else sees him.
Right, sir. Then after that, I think we need to ask Professor Burt about his Keller machine. Professor Burt? Professor Burt?
Lock the door. I don't want anyone else getting in.
Right, sir.
Let me out of here.